There we go. I believe when last we left off, we were headed off to Londinium to go find out more about those cool space dinosaurs. Yeah, these things. Oh, they're so cool. Alpha Centauri, or Toloman. All right, let's go.
All right, Captain. Where are we headed next?
This world is off limits. You are advised to jump to safe harbor immediately.
I'm glad to be here. Thank you. Is this the right planet? Seems to be. Oh, it's getting nice. Alright, so here's the plan for what's going on with this game. I like this quest. I'm going to finish this quest line. Then I think I'm going to go start the big finale. Not sure how long that's going to take, but I'm going to finish this up. I'm going to finish this quest line, do the finale, finish the game, and then go hopefully Satisfactory, which I'm really looking forward to. Love that game. This has been a fun game too, though. I'm enjoying it. Exit ship. Here we go. I shoot a training dummy. I'm not gonna risk it. I don't want to get accidentally shot as he's doing target practice or something. Where's the door? Is this the door? No, that's a wall. Oh, is this the right door? Ah, yes. Alright, here we go.
I pride myself on knowing everyone on this world, and I don't know you. You're with the collection team that I believe.
Right. Hypothermia gained.
Vanguard, eh? Brief said you were a eclectic group. You must have really shined out on the fringe to get assigned a task like this. Ah, then this must be the rest of your outfit.
Commander Hatoum.
I have no need for introductions, Major Simon. Stop.
Is it? Wait, why do I have hypothermia?
Londinian is one of the most dangerous places in the way. It's for good reason my soldiers and I do everything we can to avoid entering the city. Terramorphs are omnipresent, and the structural damage left behind when Major Sinon's father bombed its spaceport has turned large swathes of the metropolis into a decaying labyrinth. As such, we will be providing you all with gear, information, and uploading municipal unlock codes to your robot. Every tool you could need to
my robot?
Out there.
Mm-hmm.
Except
one. Do I get a robot?
Once you're on the other side of those barriers, you will be on your own. If you get into trouble, my people will not be coming. Do we understand each other?
Understood.
Precisely. I'll leave you to your preparations then. You can find your equipment in our armory, base of the tower just outside. Now, once you're outside the base, it's my personal suggestion you make a beeline to the nearby Aceles plant. It contains one of our field caches. Though I can't guarantee it won't contain anything else. I hope you all find what you're looking for out there. Robot, you're coming with me.
Yes, ma'am.
Great.
Thank you, Commander. Percival, you all set to hook into their comms tower?
Should only take a few minutes. Let's get this done and get the hell out of here.
Percival will be scanning the city for our samples from here. When he finds one, he'll transmit the coordinates to us out in the field.
Alright, let's do this.
Alright. Head over to the armory and gear up. Once you're done, we'll meet by the entrance to the city.
I mean, I might as well see what they get for me, huh? Even if it's nothing I care about, might as well see. I got some stuff there. I might as well take this to sell. Ugh, come on. Does Epitome actually do anything? Ship weapons cost more. Okay, that doesn't actually matter to me. I mean, I don't like it, but, you know. Ooh, actually, that's pretty good. Ooh, pretty good too. It's a bit better energy, but that's not bad. Ooh, pretty good. Oh, and it's still incendiary. Nice. Let's do this!
Let's get this show on the road.
Let's kill some Terramorphs and grab a dinosaur. I supposed to do something?
Kaiser?
Oh, dude. Yeah. There's some cool creature designs in this. Yeah. Ooh, look at that. Yeah. I'm liking the creature designs. Just all the good stuff, huh? Just grab everything. Grab all the loot and all the grenades. Not even sure if we'll need half this stuff, but still. Why not? Ooh, an albino pteromorph. Get slashed. You got a lot of health bars, man. Look at you with your many little health bars, compared to my one giant health bar. Although honestly, that does kind of remind me of a thing. In that TTRPG I'm making. Some like really big powerful monsters like krakens and stuff are actually going to be made up of multiple little things, you know, like you'll have kraken main body and a few tentacles and that's the whole creature. Ooh. Yeah, I'm thinking that's going to be pretty fun, you know, like, you know, like you can cut a giant robot's legs out and it'll be unable to move, but still the top part will be coming around swinging at you. What's this? Recovery rate. It's reduced? Oof. Don't like that. Hmm. only have the one thing for hypothermia? I mean, I've got two of them, but... Oh, we actually got this as well. Yeah, let's take some snake oil. And it gives me more OT recovery. Marvelous! Say who that was. Okay. Whoa! Hey. Are they trying to mind control me? Yeah, good luck, buddy. That ain't gonna work. Taking health damage expends O2. Sheesh. Super protection complete. Is there a way to regain that? Like. Did he hear the Terramorph stuff as well? Where are these steam tunnels? Oh, there's the marker over there. Did he hear the Terramorphs as well?
This flora. This is Lazarus' plant, isn't it?
Confirmed.
You know, no one even realized it was a living thing until someone got it under a microscope and saw it had cells. Can't be cultivated anywhere but Londinium.
Oh, my protections are recharging good. See, don't have anything for frostbite. No. I could do Panacea, but that feels like a bit of a waste. Okay, that's literally all I got for the Panacea, and I don't think it's worth it, so.
Real marvel.
Hopefully I can find something down here to take for that.
No, it can't be true. Heat leeches are everywhere. They live everywhere. saw that, right? You would tell me if I was losing my mind. That heat leech became a Terramorph. The pests that have snuck onto every planet are baby Terramorphs. Heat leeches hide out in ships, sneak away after landing, and then, with time, they transform. We just found out how Terramorphs move between planets.
Pretty major discovery.
Pretty major is right. But if what we just saw...
Oh, boy.
If that's possible... The Lazarus plant. It's clearly an accelerant for the Terramorph. A heat leech transformation process. Make one into the other. In an instant. But that means if anyone knew about this, they could trigger a Terramorph spawning. You could sneak a leech into a city or... even multiple leeches into a place like New Atlantis. Good God. The attack on New Atlantis, does this... Could someone have set that up?
Can't imagine what it'd take to pull off something like that.
Me neither. You'd have to know this all exists, first and foremost.
Well, we're never gonna know if you don't catch that thing. Get after it!
Okay then, well, I was wrong about my werewolf theory, but, still not great. Well, you analyze, I'm gonna see about this. Physical damage to take. Nice. I could better boost pack. I'm gonna get more boost packs. It's not bad. You know what? Let's get my shape. Ignore physical damage. Maybe. Conspiracy.
Exactly. Someone saw the Lazarus plant in action and used it to trigger the attacks. A bioweapon no one would recognize as one. Oh, that's a terrifying prospect. Sort of thing that'll keep you up at night. And the sort of thing whoever did this probably didn't expect us to uncover.
I'm starting to wonder if that's what happened here as well.
Was likely
settlers going missing. Ensure the big show, the attack on New Atlantis, would be a success. And the timing of that one. It couldn't have been just luck that it happened right when we were asking the cabinet to do something about the Terramorphs. These attacks. I think someone planned them to set all this in motion.
Yeah, I thought the timing was a bit suspicious.
They certainly were.
Yeah.
But this
hey, there's a problem.
It raises
no.
A big question.
Problem shows up.
Who Yeesh. Could pull something like this off? And why?
I have some ideas, but it's not responsible to just start hurling accusations.
Let's save the discussion for when you all aren't standing in the universe's closest equivalent to hell frozen over. If we're gonna do anything to prevent more Terramorph attacks, human cause or otherwise, we need that final sample.
Roger that.
I mean, I don't know if they would, but I'm wondering if the Starborn would have anything to do with this.
I am unable to provide sufficient power to the lock mechanism.
Anyone got ideas where we could get some extra juice?
Local power looks like it was controlled in the security office. Upper floor.
Captain and I can scout it out. Kaiser, see if you can't find another way to get it open.
Roger that.
Yes.
I have restored power to the office entrance. You may proceed.
There's the control panel. Still looks optimal. Of all the things to survive.
Power reactivated.
Med pack. Maybe I'll use that panacea once we're done with this place to get rid of these debuffs. And he's still down there. I was reading minds from Domestic.
The recording said it all. She saw the potential of the plant as a weapon and hid it away. He killed those people. Condemned.
Cold-blooded murder.
Yes. Exactly what we all thought he was. But I guess... I guess that's just another part of his sick legacy now. He thought he was...
As soon as we get back, I'm gonna go talk to him.
Only he didn't succeed. Now someone else knows about the Lazarus plant and is using it exactly how he feared.
We should get moving. A lot of work to do.
Right. Settled systems are counting on us. Kaiser, try it now.
There we go.
Sound good. Eyes peeled.
Melee attacks deal less damage. Okay, I gotta get rid of this. You know what? I'm just gonna use that panacea. Completely drains it too. I'll let that regen a bit. Is it gonna pop? Yep, there it is. Yeah. Chop its legs. Oh boy! Hasta la vista, sucker. Okay, I'm gonna power up these dishes, try and get rid of stuff. How much am I? 3 pounds. Alright, let's, honestly, I haven't picking up a lot of this. Few of those.
All wrapped up. Time to get the hell out of here. Percival, you should unplug and find somewhere we can talk. Privately.
On it. See you soon.
Do I have to go all the way back, or am I able to do? I kinda like those tusk frogs, they're cute. These grazers are pretty cool. These like, grazer things are pretty cool too. Man, if this was Ark, I would so want to tame one of these things as a mount. They look cool, I like them. Is it still gonna work that we gotta clean up heat leeches and thermals?
Can't be positive until we run some tests. But knowing that the thermals have been masquerading as heat leeches all this time, it's a big find. Arguably makes things more feasible now that we know what we're dealing with.
Of course, that frostbite.
Agreed. Plus, I don't think you're gonna have to push real hard to get folks on board with cleaning up one of the galaxy's greatest pests if this is what they're capable of.
But none of that's getting done without the samples. You do have them, right?
You do. Kansas got them in storage.
Ah, best place for them. Now, my connection might have gotten a bit fuzzy there, but do I have it right that Vae Victus knew about this damn plant?
That's what it sounded like.
Guess the old Admiral must have told someone what he learned. Even he's not clever enough to pull off an attack like that from the great beyond.
Quick save.
At least we can rule out one.
Can't rule out. He's alive on the easy custom.
I'm sorry. What?
Captain, now's really not the time to be making cracks like that.
He's alive. Sorry I didn't tell you before.
No. No, that can't be. I saw him. He's actually really alive? That what all this time and decided now was the time to bring it up.
You swore
you were just doing your duty. I'm glad you told me. It certainly does. He's alive. Vae Victus is still alive. Oh, this is just typical of UC bureaucracy. A cover-up of this magnitude could directly lead to war. What the hell is the matter with them? It also makes my father the only solid lead we've got on the attacks. Look, Percival and I, we need to tend to these samples. Guarantee we'll be able to handle cleaning up the leeches as well as the terramorphs. But I think you, Captain, should get in contact with my father and find out what he might know about the attacks.
Oh, he and I are gonna have some words.
outside the cabinet chambers.
I'm not sure if I should have said that, but
thank you for dealing with him.
Buddy, you and me are gonna have some work. And they ain't gonna be the friendly type. Let's go give this war criminal a piece of our mind.
Well, what a pleasant surprise. When I heard you and Hadrian were headed for Londinium of all places, I presumed you must be onto something big. Did you find what you were looking for?
I don't know. Is there anything you want to tell me about your time in Londinium? An recording of you discussing the use of Terramorphs as a weapon.
Did you? Well, I don't know what you think you heard on this recording, but I sincerely hope you didn't come to the wrong conclusions. After all, given the cabinet's current state of anxiety, they might misinterpret such a discovery. Me and I get a bit involved in the attacks. Perhaps I can convince you to keep this among us.
That's a good. No more lies. Confess or I turn over what I found.
You know, you're far more clever than I expected. You want to hear the words, then. I did it. The Terramorph attacks on Tau City. New Atlantis. My doing. Years of coordination between my associate and I. Figuring out how to deploy the Lazarus plant's pollen outside of Londinium. Learning to synthesize it.
Work on something that long seems personal.
You couldn't be more right. The attacks were a correction. When I discovered the plant, I did consider handing over what I found, but we were at war. And I couldn't risk information that dangerous falling into the wrong hands. So I ordered the bombing of the Londinium
You said to... I feel like something like this should have been in the Armistice archives.
It's easy to judge now, but the Freestar Collective had spies everywhere. In that moment, I wasn't about to add another dangerous variable to an already catastrophic war. But then, as the war ended, my trial, my execution, I made a decision. After all, I'd given everything for the colonies.
Yes.
There are no heroes without a villain. I simply arranged the opportunity for us to overcome one and become the other. And we all benefited. It's why I had Orlais reprogram Kaiser. Had that old machine guide you to where I found the plant all those years ago.
If you're waiting for me to say thank you, you're gonna be here a while.
I'm simply looking for you to acknowledge the truth. And let's not forget the importance of our actual endgame. Eliminating the Terramorphs. Securing knowledge of the Lazarus plant. What we've set in motion is going to protect thousands, maybe millions of lives. I'm simply requesting one more life be protected. Mine. I've already sent along the evidence of Orlais's role in the attacks to the cabinet, leaving out my own involvement. All I ask is that you confirm as much to the cabinet. Tell them that it was Orlais.
I don't think I'm gonna.
After all, I do still have a long list of threats to the UC. This needn't be the end of our good works together.
I'm gonna ignore the fact you kill people to accomplish your good works.
And how many have you killed to get where you are now? There are no great works that don't cost lives, Captain. Whether it's winning a war or digging a tram tunnel. So we sacrificed a few dozen in the attacks to possibly protect millions. That seems like a fair exchange to me. I only hope you'll see the same and leave my name out of the discussions to come.
Hope you enjoyed this talk. Once I tell the captain, it'll probably be our last.
That is a pity, Captain. But I'm in no position to negotiate. Though we needn't be enemies, you and I. Just think about the opportunity I've provided here. There are more on the horizon. If you do the right thing.
I'm not. I don't think I'm gonna side with the war criminal.
How are things?
Let's go.
Excellent.
He organized attacks so that we could learn what he already knew. He could have just told us or given that to the captain himself. He didn't need to throw monsters at people. Oh, here we are. Gotta save before I do this.
Timing. We just got in.
So on our end, good news. The microbe and the Aceles are both as effective against
nice.
These leeches as they are against Terramorphs.
Means either plan should work for clearing those critters off our worlds.
Considering what the Lazarus plant is capable of, I don't think we can deal with those things fast enough.
Hmm.
I already sent along info to the cabinet to get them up to speed. So what about your end? Did you find anything? Did my father tell you what he knew about the Lazarus plant?
Confessed. Organized the attacks from his cell.
I knew it. The second I heard that recording, I knew.
Why? Did he say why he did it?
You're trying to fix damage done to something. Make you and him into heroes.
It takes some deeply twisted logic to think anything did more harm to the Sanan name than him.
So you're telling us that the attack on New Atlantis was very Victus's responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
Just like the dooming of London. Oh, that's insane. All that just to help restore the family name. How did he ever think that was going to work?
Well, once we inform the cabinet, they can ensure he won't be able to do anything like this ever again.
Honestly, I feel like this boils down to cool motive, still murder. Honestly, I feel like he deserves some punishment.
Exactly. Bring justice to everyone he's hurt. So I guess that gives us our final answer. Nothing left to do but head in and see what the cabinet thinks of it all. Unless there was more to discuss. This might be our last opportunity to talk things through before the cabinet weighs in on a decision regarding the Terramorphs.
What were you two leaning towards?
Microbe is going to make the cleanup a whole lot quicker. If we're concerned about this Lazarus plant getting deployed again, that's the way to go.
The cabinet can secure the Lazarus plant, and then we're not risking any surprises when it comes to dealing with a microbe.
You're being paranoid. You know the science. You know we can make this safe.
I do know the science. I also know math. And a 1 in 1,000,000 chance of a mutation isn't zero. So I guess we're still in discussion. Probably best at this point to let the cabinet wait. See if they have a preference.
What risks are there if we bring back these Aceles?
Aceles aren't hostile to humans, but they are mega fauna. If someone decides to pick a fight with one, it could get ugly. But they've already been spread far and wide once before when the UC was raising them as livestock, so the risk of introducing them to new worlds is minimal. Using them to clean up the Terramorphs and leeches, though, it's not going to be nearly as expedient as the microbe would be. Given what we know now about the Lazarus plant, the speed of the job does matter. But going with the Aceles, we're at least dealing with known risks.
Perfect. Those are effective. Right.
Microbe needed minimal adjustment to account for heat leech anatomy.
And the Aceles seem like they're even better at tracking leeches than morphs.
Hell of a sight to watch, though, when they catch them. Like an open airlock guzzling angry spaghetti.
Yeah. I'm still leaning towards the Asili's. Combined with a shoot on sight policy. E for the heat leeches. What do you think they'll do? Yeah, but
it's hard to know. Unlike my father, the cabinet aren't butchers. But killing UC citizens, along with everything else he's done, is unforgivable. But if you're really that concerned, you could request they be lenient. They might be willing to spare him.
Alright, nothing else on my mind? Let's go.
Here we go. Welcome back, all of you. I wish we were meeting under better circumstances. But according to Hadrian's report and the second one I just received, it seems the Terramorph attack on New Atlantis was no random occurrence, but a planned strike. Is what I'm reading here true?
But don't you worry, we found the culprit.
The second report claims to know the perpetrator as well. Did Reginald Orlais actually commit these attacks, Captain? Orlais?
It's not the whole truth. Orlais helped, but Vae Victus organized the attacks.
It's true, ma'am. I heard the recording myself. My father figured out how to use Terramorphs as weapons.
He did what?
That's impossible. He doesn't have the kind of access to...
Clearly, he made his own access, Chief Sarkin. Madam President, I have been saying for years that not dealing with that man was going to end in tragedy.
Enough! I hope everyone here understands that what has just been shared is a state secret of the highest order. This information does not leave this room. Now, that's quite the accusation you're leveling. Considering Francois Sinon has not left containment for the better part of 2 decades. You have evidence to back this up?
Play emergency recorder snippet.
It just transformed a Terramorph out of thin air. An invisible weapon. No planet would be safe.
Heavens help us. Is that actually him?
I'd know that voice anywhere. That's Francois.
He knew they could do this. And said nothing.
Mm-hmm. He's a sociopath. Plain and simple, ma'am.
Officer, please collect that recording.
Yes, ma'am. Begging your pardon, Captain?
Of course.
We'll, of course, be launching a full investigation into how this could have happened. Though I have little doubt the Admiral will be quick to share all he knows on the subject once confronted with that recording. Chief Yassin, can you send one of your interrogators to have a little chat with the Admiral?
I'll issue the order immediately.
Good. Combined with everything else you all have uncovered. Well, I don't think the United Colonies can thank you enough. We failed the people of the colonies by not dealing with Vae Victus sooner. I intend to rectify that mistake immediately.
Was the good?
I'm inclined to agree, Captain. Now, with our villain unmasked, we can attend to the other matters at hand. With the threads you brought together here, the Lazarus plant, the attacks, the heat leeches, the three of you have likely spared thousands of lives. But it now falls to the cabinet to ensure this can never happen again. As such, the cabinet will be securing the Lazarus plant on Londinium. All materials related to the plant will be classified to ensure no one else learns its true nature.
A sound decision, Madam President.
What sort of measures will be taken?
Well, luckily the natural hostility of Londinium makes keeping out trespassers relatively easy. But we'll ensure its growth is contained. That access to the plant is only permitted via highly regulated clearances, and that our troop presence on Londinium is increased.
Honestly, I'm not sure if it's worth keeping. Like, if this was an option, I'd say this feels worthy of throwing in the Armistice Archives, but yeah, it's not an option here, so maybe just say get rid of it. Okay. Because honestly, admittedly, all I know about it is that it causes monsters to spawn, but still, that's not good.
On you, Captain. We're already discussing the elimination of one species, Captain. Explain to me why you wish to eliminate another.
Strength.
Yes, absolutely. The UC has to be as transparent as possible from now on.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we could be risking a second colony war.
That is an idea with some merit to it. Decrease the likelihood of anything like this occurring again, and further relations between our two factions.
Two birds with a single stone. Very well. We'll include the collective in the removal process. Thank you for the suggestion, Captain.
Mm-hmm.
So then, to our final topic. The Cabinet has agreed to implement a plan that will deal with the Terramorph, and now also Heatleech, presence on human worlds. In fact, we've already begun enacting measures to check all UC ports and settlements for undiscovered nests. But we all understand this is only a partial solution. The project we're embarking on will be a long and difficult one. So our first step must be deciding how exactly this all will be handled.
Madam President, this microbe is clearly too much of a risk. The Acelia.
I'm liking this Yassin fellow.
Someone with limited knowledge of biology, perhaps. The technology behind the microbe is solved science, Madam President. It isn't dangerous. Using it to wipe out the Terramorphs would be the quickest path to protecting humanity.
And fast results always lead to the best outcomes.
As you can see, there remains debate among the Cabinet. We were hoping your group might issue a recommendation. Major?
We've been having similar debates ourselves, but the Captain has yet to weigh in.
I see. Captain, I know this may not be your area of expertise, but we'd like to know your take on the matter.
Deploying the Aceles. Yeah.
I'm in full agreement. No need to be delving into unpredictable sciences.
Here's hoping they'll be kept on a short leash.
That, madam, is most certainly the plan.
Order, please. And Major Sinan? Dr. Walker? You'd find this acceptable?
We trust the Captain's judgment.
Then the matter is settled.
Alright! Time for dinosaurs!
Today marks day one for the United Colonies Terramorph Management Division, making you three the founding members of the TMD. As befits such a group, the Cabinet wanted to display its gratitude. Today, we will be adding three new
class one citizens
to our ranks.
Class one? For the three of us? Are you joking?
What he means to say is thank you, ma'am.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
All right. What's a class one citizen?
It's a status reserved only for those who've dedicated their lives to the United Colonies or done great things for the cause. Class 1s enjoy an ample credit disbursement, an additional reduction on the cost of colonial goods, and I'm told the penthouse is Rather impressive.
Thank you.
Now, there's much to be done. Major Sinan, Dr. Walker, I hope you two are willing to continue your efforts, spearheading the TMD's research on Mars.
We'd be honored, ma'am.
As for you, Captain, the Vanguard will be providing much of the on-the-ground support for the TMD. As a member of both the Vanguard and the TMD, I believe you'll have your pick of duties. Speak to your commander, Tuala, if I recall correctly. He should be able to provide you with assignments going forward, plus help you collect the benefits that come with being named Class 1. On behalf of the whole of the United Colonies, you have our sincerest gratitude.
Yeah, there we go. Honestly, I kind of love the idea that my guy just kind of wandered in, fought a bunch of monsters, and everyone's praising him for it now. He clearly has no intentions of... He clearly has no idea what any of this is, didn't care about the UC citizenship. But he's like, yeah, sure, I'll take it. Alright. Alright, let's go to the eye. Alright, I'm gonna...
That was a pleasant change of scenery.
Well, for the second half of this stream, let's see if there's any more temples to go find. Hey.
Gave up my room in the lodge so Andresia had a place to call her own. Everyone needs space to let their thoughts run solo.
Alright. Somebody can point me toward the artifact temple.
Got one. I'd go into the astronomical charting data with you, but clear as day just to point you right to it.
Fair enough. Alright, let's see how far away this is. Oh, not that bad. All right, let's get in here. All right, there we go. Okay, there we go. Sorry, I just saw a gun shape in the bottom corner. I was like, wait, do I have a gun equipped for some reason? But no, I just was a little thing. A little visual glitch or whatever. Is that gaseous platinum? Or is this just a lot of platinum down here? Must have been the cutter that I saw in the corner. Oh, just noticed I have a viewer. Hello there. You're just in time to watch me you get new magic power from that cool temple over there. Wonder what I'll get. Good to get back to basics, you know? Hey, my frostbite's cured. Thanks, Magic Temple. Even though it didn't really have anything to do with it, it's just natural healing, but still. Into the portal. They forgot I had that mustache. Alien reanimation. Did I just get zombie powers? Hold on. Where is it? Creator. Alien reanimation. I got zombie powers. Let's just head back to the Razor Leaf before I get frostbite again. Remember to use these powers, you know?
Back among the
oh, is that Sarah?
Heavenly Celestial, it must feel good for you to see your family.
How's it going? Talk to you soon.
Okay. Okay. Missions. Let's just go back. You know, let's see what all the different temples do. Obviously, they probably act the same, but, you know. Let's get the powers. We'll, okay. Sarah, you gotta get off my lap. I gotta drive here. Centauri. Go back to the eye. Okay, let's land there and then let's go back. Back into our ship, hopefully without Sarah Hera in our lap.
Archaeologists back in New Atlantis that would need their left arm to be here right now.
Okay, this way. There we go. Thank you. Alright, now let's head back to the eye. Oh boy. With the big balls and the thing closing, it looks kinda like a mouth going shipping.
What are we going to do now?
I'd be happy to tell someone you're here. Wait, what? Oh! Boy, I was not expecting that, but free ship parts, I guess? Boy. Let's do some transfer stuff. take all resources. Oh, wow. Resources is what it really got me. So, yeah. And I'll, now I'll loot those ship parts and stuff. And, step one, go to, my home on Olympus. Yeah. Just drop off all these crafting materials. Store all, at least as much as I can. Our inventory resources, store all. Still a lot there, so decorate. Have aluminum in either of these. Aromatic, nope. Resources, adhesive, nope. Oh, that's not actually your. Not actually container. So they're all the same thing, they just look different. Is this actually something I can use? I don't know, so I'll build one and hope that I can actually use it. Nope, it's useless. I wonder if I can just drop them here and they'll still be here, you know? I'm gonna save just in case. Opening. inventory, resources. Okay, here we go. Wow, that's a lot of junk. If I leave and come back, will it still be here? The pile is safe for now. Good enough. Feeling kind of bad about leaving it all like that. Should I go like, just cheat some aluminum in just to make some chests? That's fine.
You are entering United Colony space. Maintain course and prepare to be scanned. Scan complete. Go ahead and land.
What if there's some...
Never regretted coming out of retirement. Constellations got the writ of the righteous. And the darkness gets lit just a candle more.
Okay, there we go.
The eyes showing signs over another one of those big... One too many squats. Jaw the words another time, then.
Toast City. Actually, is that where my... Is that where the big thing is? Oh, it's Masada Thunum. Although there is another Tau City here. Two things at once. Alright. An abandoned farm. Curious if there's anything there. Being abandoned, the lights are on, so. Is this pirates, or is this just for game mechanics? Pack Ankylosaurus? Defensive. Oh, okay. These things still look cool. Oh, med pack. Yeah. Aluminum. Definitely need that for more boxes. Credits. Some spacesuits. Nah. Impact grenade. Nice. Credits and a digipick. Also, I saw some gunfire coming, and I don't think these things can use firearms yet. Is there someone friendly over here, or is there someone angry over here? Something to be done. They're dangerous.
Yes, exactly. I'm glad you treated the situation with the urgency it deserved. I only wish that the United Colonies chose to exterminate the Terramorphs with the experimental microbe instead of choosing this ridiculous Acili solution. Best shot.
Was it that turret that was shooting them down? Not like some lone farmer or pirate or something. Okay. Fair enough. Uh, Yeah, let's just go back there.
Get this shit moving.
Oh, second viewer, hello there. Hey, now we got a party going. Also, one sec. It bugged me for a bit, but the thing wasn't fully clicked. In any case, let's see where this thing is. Is that it over there? Maybe. That seems like something. Hey! How's Starfield? I'm having a good time! I'm having a really good time. Fun game. Ah, there's the temple. Yeah, I'm just about to go. Oh, get an alien magic power. Because I'm apparently a space wizard. Having a good day? I am having a good day. Something funny actually kind of happened to me earlier. This week we're getting our kitchen kind of repainted, getting our kitchen painted and stuff to move around. So there's a lot of stuff going on in there. You're a Jedi, Harry? Yeah, pretty much. Like, look at some of these powers. Alien reanimation, solar flare. Sense star stuff, gravity wave, personal atmosphere, grav dash. And let's see what this new one is. Yeah, these are kind of fun. You get new powers by going into these weird temples, floating around in zero gravity. And popping these kind of little bubble things with your face. Boop. Wait, you've heard getting the powers is kind of boring? I mean, it's not super thrilling, like... Honestly, this whole thing is pretty cool the first time, but after a couple of them, it's like, okay, this is just this again. Might have been nice if they added in, like, a couple different mini-games or something, you know? Like, one of them is flying around popping bubbles. Another one is some sort of, like, little logic puzzle, something like that. But who cares, because now I got a new magic power. Let's see what it is. Eternal Harvest. Ooh. What's up, sir?
Sorry to pull you aside like this. Hmm? Taking those steps to...
Oh.
Yes.
Apparently we got interrupted last time.
I only wish that... Apparently their decision was based on your recommendation. That was a risky choice you've made.
That was minimal risk.
Minimal risk. Are you sure? The Asili solution
revolution might take years, perhaps even decades. Meanwhile, the clock is ticking for humankind. That sounds far too risky to me. I'm sorry to hear that, but what's done is done. The Asili's method has been deployed, so we'll have to wait and see if it's effective. Thankfully, the eradication of the Lazarus plant gives the Asili's a bit more time to do their job.
Even if we don't agree, I appreciate your honesty.
Of course. I wouldn't have it any other way.
Time to harvest the force.
I appreciate the fact that you've taken the time to listen to my opinion on the matter.
Yeah. So yeah, because you weren't there, basically a bunch of monsters were rampaging around. Hey. Sorry, one sec. Just gotta fight this guy. Oh, there you go. Your fancy guns are no match for my stabbing technology. Let's see what this new power does. Where is it? Eternal Harvest. When its blossoms will bloom once more, ripe for the picking. Oh, does this just, like... Does this, like, regenerate nodes or something? Like, resource nodes? Interesting. Also, since we're already in Tau City, let's just head over there. Oh, I can't. I'm like jumping or something. Let's go to the South Pole to investigate this anomaly. 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 There it is. Yeah, honestly, I think I might just get the rest of these. I think I might just get the rest of these powers and then. Oh, is that it right there? Yep, it's right there. Excellent. I think I'm gonna get the rest of the powers, then go to the finale. Looks like finale might have to be next time though, since it's already getting to be near 5. Do have alien reanimation active, good. Temple Omnicron. Only if I had to program a car or tank or mech. Yeah, I think that would be really cool to. I think that'd be a really cool cool ability to either buy a little speeder bike or maybe use what's it the. Maybe at like high levels of zoology skill, you can tame a creature to ride around on, something like that. space game, imagination is the only limit. Yeah, though. Yeah, and, honestly, I do think that some sort of mount or vehicle or something would be really cool. Yeah. I was kind of wish this game would take a cue from Rodina for its planets. So instead of just a bunch of little spaces all separated off, it'd just be one full planet, you know? Get back here, where is it? Yeah! Did I miss it? Yeah! There we go. At least the horse, I mean, it didn't scare me. Yeah. I mean, if they didn't want to do animals, because that's like, it's like a space game, it'd be weird to just have a weird space horse on your ship. I'd like it, but I mean, I get that. Yeah, I get why they wouldn't want that, because it feels a bit tonally clashing, but at least give me a speeder bike or something. No. Ooh, what's this gonna be? Void form. Excellent.
I picked up something you might be interested in.
Not that. Although we have a skill point, actually. I should, look at that. Void form. Channel very darkness of space, rendering yourself nearly invisible. Ooh, invisibility mode. Nice. Beyond. Let's go. Yeah.
This is UC Security. Prepare to be scanned for contraband.
So need to create a car mod for following the Vegas. The engine is. Yeah. I'm, yeah, I don't think that the. I don't think that it's, oh, we can't do it. It's just, oh, we didn't bother to do it. And I admit they did put a lot into this game, so I can see why my mounts weren't the big thing, but still, it feels like something that should be in here, you know? Calm down, Seraph. Yeah, like, they've got horses in Skyrim, so I'm sure they could figure out how to make something like that mechanically work in space. But, they just didn't bother, is probably.
Oh, sorry. I was just doing some. The eyes showing signs over another.
Let's do this. Scan this. Anomaly in space. There's planets here, yeah. Yeah. Also, side note about planets. I wish that they were just one big thing, you know, like. How do I get to a local map? G service map. So this is just kind of a little swatch of land with a couple weird little things in it. Which, I mean, it works for the game. But yeah. Oh, imagine if they did that and introduced racing the games. Oh, that would be cool. Oh, well, there's the temple. Ooh, also, I just noticed I'm half health. So let me throw a med pack on. 9 of those. Good. Yeah, some sort of racing minigame would be awesome. Maybe that's even how you get a mount. Like, you are introduced to some sort of space horse racing. And after the end of the quest line, you get to keep a space horse. I know World of Warcraft's done some stuff like that, where you get to, like, raise a little creature, and then at the end of the quest line, you get it as, like, a mount or a pet or something. And I always like those, you know? There's some sort of jetpack boost, like Mass Effect and Dragon. Yeah, there is a jetpack. There are jetpacks, yes. Yeah, if your thing has this little thing here saying boost pack, then yes, you can use it as a jetpack. Also, I got a thing. You can also get different levels of stuff. Like, you can now use jetpacks, and using it costs less fuel. Oh, I meant boosting forward. Oh, I don't think so. Sadly, no. There's a sprint, but there's no, like, boost forward. Yeah, sorry, I haven't played the Mass Effect games. I've seen some stuff from them, but never played them. Third viewer, we're kicking off, huh? I should just notice, every time I've gone into a temple this stream, I've gotten a new viewer. Apparently people really want to see me fly around like this. Where's the next one? Oh, there it is. Boy, here we go. Also, while I have people here, quick thing, I've got a poll on my Twitter for what game I should play for my big 24-hour stream coming up. I'm thinking sometime this summer. So yeah, if you want to see the options and vote for your favorite, I got a poll on Twitter. Oh, okay. Quite cool for some played entire trilogy last summer. You got the EA place up for 60 cents. Nice. I was a child. I think my dad might have played through at least some elemental pole. Ooh. That sounds kind of useful. What's that? Where is that? Oh, there it is. Elements to truth. As your planet and moon are drawn to your being. But yeah, I think my dad played Mass Effect at one point. Maybe I could borrow them from him. Is it Xenos? Best travel, yes. He had something to say. Or give me, or whatever.
Some religions say our lives are circular. Well, I hope the next time around, we're just as close as we are now.
I've got a moment. What's up?
You have anything?
I do. You must have read my mind.
Hmm. A leaf. Thanks. Thanks, Sarah. A neat leaf. Oh, yeah. And then you saw a sale for Mass Effect Legendary Edition for 16. Mmm, yeah. Good for you. It's a good bargain. Later?
So, what's new with you today? We'll talk again.
Okay. Right. Yeah, good deal. Getting it for a third of the price. Nice. Oh, does he not have any more? Oh, okay. Well, you know what? Let's go to Masada 3.
Where shall we swim to next, oh wise and formidable captain?
Although I think that just going there will be the end of the stream. Oh. Gonna have to bounce between a few who plans to get there, eh? Yeah. Oh, first game dropped down to 8 here, so you're not playing. It's a good game. Nice! Yeah, maybe Mass Effect will go on the streaming list at some point. Here we go. But yeah. I'm gonna... Yeah. Yeah, in a bit. Funny you mention that when we're on the way to the finale. Go through Heisenberg. Oh, I leveled up again. Nice. I got 2 skill points to spend now. Legendary is quality of life improvements, better graphics, and includes all the games. Oh, I'm glad I got this adoring fan. It's great. He's great. Although, to be fair, I did kind of set myself up for having a good life. My 3 starting traits were alien DNA, adoring fan, and a house, so... Andromeda's exception, Legendary doesn't include it. Hmm, okay. I think I'm gonna end it here. Next time, we're going to Masada. And we're going to go to the finale. If it doesn't work, we'll reload. What? Oh. Where are you? I'm about to die. Oh. Yeah, I don't think I've spent a single point in the ship combat in this playthrough. So yeah, hopefully it's not an omen of things to come, but next time, we're going to the finale. Should be a lot of fun. Looking forward to seeing how this all kicks out, how this all shakes out, you know? I'm also really looking forward to getting the Satisfactory. That is such a good game. Love it a bunch. Really excited to play that again. But this is... this has been a really fun game, too. I've been enjoying it. Maybe I'll go back through and make another character. Maybe actually use guns this time. Probably heavy guns, because me, but still, you know. Yeah. Pretty good place to leave it off, just before the finale. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Thank you, VanAndle7800, for actually talking. And I'll hopefully see everyone back here next time. Don't forget to vote on the Twitter poll. And I'll see you then. Bye.